So now, let's understand the correlations of everything we've just learned. What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about bringing together what you've learned of Mesh, what you've learned of objects, the 3D cursor in Origin, and putting them all together so you start to understand where I'm going with this. Frankly, it's one of those fundamental building blocks within Blender that isn't covered early enough within the Blender learning curve, be it precision modeling or not. But within precision modeling, this is so crucial because it is the fundamental step to understand how to get precision movement, and then how an add-on uses that exact type of precision movement style to get incredible sub-millimeter precision within a mesh workflow. So here we are within a nice, fresh new Blender file, and this video is all about sort of the connection points of all the information we've understand so far. So we know that this cube is made of this mesh within edit mode that has vertices, edges, and faces, and then all of this is within an object, and this object has this origin point, and the origin point is sort of very closely connected with the 3D cursor, because when you go ahead and you make a new object, it has its own origin point there, and it's in the center of that object. But that's about as far as we've got, really. So let's go ahead, let's delete what I've just done there. And something that I probably didn't put across too well in the last video is that everything here that you're seeing is an object. This camera is an object. It has an origin point. This light is an object. It has an origin point. Yes, you cannot take this camera into edit mode, because what is there to edit? There is no mesh within it. There is nothing editable within the camera. But for objects that contain mesh, they can very much be put into edit mode. So let's go ahead and let's go into edit mode with this object. So we know here we have this collection of mesh that creates this cube. Now, what we did in the last video is we were duplicating objects. So what happens if we use our Shift D and duplicate within edit mode with everything selected? Well, it duplicates things, that's for sure. And we can constrain it exactly the same. We can set units in exactly the same. And we can hit enter. But have you seen what is fundamentally different? There is only one origin point here. That is because now this object that was called cube has two cubes. So let's go ahead and let's rename this. Renaming, do you remember the shortcut? It's F2, and let's actually call this Object 1. So Object 1 has the mesh information of two separate cubes. I think you're starting to understand now the real correlation between mesh and object here. Now let's go ahead and let's say that I wanted this to be two separate objects. So let's go into edit mode, and you'll see that this is already all selected. Another way of selecting sort of this separated mesh is using Control L, and that is selects linked. So with that all selected, let's go ahead and part this mesh from the object. Now I exaggerate that because in Blender it's called separate, but we're going to be using the shortcut key of P, and this is for parting what we have within our object into its own thing, and we're going to go by selection this time round. So by selection, go back into object mode, and you're going to see that we have object 1 and then object 1.001. So this means that this cube that we duplicated from its mesh now is an object, and it's inherited the name of where it's come from. So let's go ahead and let's rename this, and let's call it Object 2. And this Object 2 has something quite interesting. The origin point is over here. What on earth is going on? Like, we are used to seeing an origin point inside of all the meshes we've been creating so far. That is because it actually doesn't matter whatsoever. The origin point is completely independent of the information that it holds. So that means origin points can be moved, and lo and behold, guess what controls that? The 3D cursor. So let's go ahead and let's snap on to vertices, and let's snap on to, onto this vertex here. Okay, so we've snapped the 3D cursor there, and now what happens? How do I move this origin point to there? Well, I make sure I have what I want selected. I right click on it, and you'll see this lovely menu right there that says Set Origin. Now you can go ahead and set the origin to geometry, which is the default way that objects come in. It's sort of the median center of mass, but it's just sort of approximately calculated, because you'll see when we get into more complicated things that can move the origin point sort of into space as well. But what was more interesting is this one here, origin to 3D cursor. Now, the main thing that I want you to remember is that the origin point is the origin of also movement, scale, and rotation within object mode by default. Yes, this can be changed, and I'll show you how to do that in the future, but just for now, keep it that simple. So, now we know that we can move the origin point, and that the 3D cursor controls a lot with the origin point. So let's go ahead and let's snap the 3D cursor here. And the 3D cursor had a snapping menu. Do you remember that shortcut? That is Shift S. And yes, this is where we can move the 3D cursor to its world origin, but it's also where we can move the selection to the cursor. So within object mode, the selection obviously has an origin point, and that's what we're moving, which means we are now precisely moving this origin point to the snapped 3D cursor, and right there is how you do very precise movement. Yes, this is extremely long-winded, but I want you to understand this before we jump into some much more advanced movement controls, which we won't be using this at all, but it's very fundamental because it works off the principles of this. So let's go ahead and let's duplicate object one here. So that was Shift D. Let's constrain it on the X. Let's go 5 millimeters, but in the other direction, and let's hit enter. So let's say that I wanted the mesh information inside of this object. Let's go ahead and rename it now. Let's go object three. Let's say the mesh information inside of object three, I want that to be a part of object two, because I really like where its origin point is. I don't know. Let's say this was the doorknob on a door, and this is the door, and it's going to swing open from there. Well, to do this, order of selection is very important, because I'm sure you might have noticed something a little bit strange. So, for instance, if we go into edit mode and we select everything, and maybe you were selecting things individually, you have this one white vertex. This is the active point, the active vertex, or what is active of the selection. Usually it's the last one that you've selected. In object mode, it's exactly the same. If you select two things, you're going to see that there's this darker outline and this lighter outline. That's because this is the active selection. You can sort of think of it that this here is the parent of this child. This does most of the controlling aspects of what's going on. And that is important because we're about to join two objects. And considering that two objects have two origin points, we need to tell Blender which origin point we want to keep. And as you can imagine, we're going to keep the parents. So let's go Control J. And now you can see that the origin point has just disappeared from this cube. It's now all in object two, and that is the main thing that I wanted you to understand. So now let's quickly separate these once again, because I want to show you that there's a quick way of separating loose objects. So back into edit mode, let's deselect basically everything here. Let's go P, and you're going to see loose parts. So if you have loose mesh, this is the quickest way of basically separating everything. So there we have it, loose parts. But you will see our object that was object three now has its origin point back over there. Let's set its origin point back to the geometry like this. And it has also inherited where it is just being released from. So it's now object 2.001. And that there fundamentally is what I wanted to get across, which is this whole idea of origin points, 3D cursors, and how they really influence each other. A huge well done for getting this far along in the series. Yes, I know Blender fundamentals can feel like they go on forever, but you're almost there. You're almost over the speed bump that is Blender fundamentals. And believe me when I say, I really do think that for how far you are along in such short amount of time, for some people that have been doing and learning Blender for maybe even 3 or 4 months, you know more about the fundamentals of Blender than they do. That's for sure. If you want a little something extra, stick to the end. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome and it means so much to me. In fact, it's the real reason why I can do things like this. And if you're enjoying what I'm doing here and think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord, and that is linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue. And for the bold of you that have made it to the end of the video, there is a short little obstacle course down in the description, along with a solution video to check your answers.